Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat tengah hari, salam sejahtera, salam Ibu Pertiwiku. Yang berhormat Datuk Dr. Jarib Susel, Menteri Muda Pengangkutan Negeri Sarawak. Yang berbahagia Kakanda Datuk Abang Haji Abdul Karim, Pengerusi Blok.Yad. Yang berhormat Saudara Dr. Hazlan bin Abang Kidni, adun kita di kawasan Demak Laut. Seterusnya, yang berbahagia Saudara Mazuin, Senior Vice President Petronas and his team. Yang bersuha ahli-ahli Lembaga Lindungan Produk.Yad dan seterusnya ketua-ketua jabatan, tuan-tuan, puan-puan serta kakitangan Produk.Yad yang saya hormati sekalian. Pertama kali saya mengucap tahniah kepada pihak Produk.Yad di atas kejayaan pada hari ini. Pertama, saya mengucap tahniah kerana hari ini kita menyaksikan peresmian Demak Fabrication Yard di kawasan yang baru ini. Tahniah kepada Demak.Yad. Yang kedua, saya mengucap tahniah kerana hari ini kita dapat menyaksikan loadout of Boko di substructure dan juga completion of Tanjung Topside. Ini adalah satu kejayaan dari pihak Demak.Yad. Ketiga, saya ucap tahniah kerana Demak.Yad mempunyai prestasi kerja yang begitu tinggi sekali. Tidak ada kemalangan. Safety record which is very high. Jadi tiga-tiga ini kalau dikombine adalah satu kejayaan yang besar yang diperolehi oleh Demak.Yad. But for the first time, if you are, people want to know Demak.Yad, Demak.Yad is a dockyard. Normally, dockyard is something to do with ships. But today, it has diversified its capability. Now, Demak.Yad is also involved in high engineering work, including providing the needs of oil and gas industry. Hari ini, kita menyaksikan bahawa Demak.Yad established in 1912. Coincident ataupun tidak coincident, minyak kita 1910. So we got, there is some relevance between the oil and gas industry with establishment of Demak.Yad, though at the time Demak.Yad was only involved in shipbuilding or repair of boats. But with that background in history, I understand that Demak.Yad has expanded. They have about 400 personnel with 99% Sarawakian, 60 engineers, 50 QA QC personnel, 110 workers and other non-technical supporting group. And of course, the general workers. Talking about this yard, as you know, the total area of land is 60 acres. And it is hoped that this fabrication will be one of the largest fabrication yards in Sarawak. And of course, will deliver whatever task given to this Demak.Yad. I was told, as mentioned by the chairman, It has a capacity of 16,500 metric tons, compared with 8,500 metric tons from Sejingkat Yard. And therefore, the overall fabrication capacity for the yard is 25,000 metric tons. I would also like to record my appreciation to the yard for successfully obtaining ISO 45001 in this 2018. And this did a real success for Brook Dot Yard. Congratulations. Apa yang kita perlu di sini ialah bahawa kejayaan Brook Dot Yard ini, there are two important factors that bring about the success of Brook Dot Yard. Number one, I think, is the question of high integrity. Integrity is a very important aspect in all management. And if you read the textbook, you read your experience for any successful organization, integrity is the key. Number two is the question of compliance. Once you comply with the work that you do based on the various rules and regulation, and therefore, I think with that compliance, your KPI will be achieved. When you talk about KPI, it also involves delivery. That is why today we are very fortunate that Brook Dot Yard can deliver what has been promised to Petronas. And if you have that success, Petronas must also promise to give more work to Brook Dot Yard. It has to be both sides. Because to achieve the work, to achieve your objective, both sides must respect each other based on capability. And Sarawak is emphasizing on that. That's why Sarawak government has a unit called Integrity and Ombudsman. And we are working together with SPRM. We have one SPRM officer seconded to the Sarawak government. And we are training what we call certified integrity officers to make sure that the question of accountability and delivery are giving top priority. And therefore, it is the target of the government that all agencies under the Sarawak government will have this culture within them. And with that, I'm sure that we can deliver whatever project given to us. As for Brook Dot Yard, you have achieved your Anjong project, your Bokor project. Nanti ada projek baru, mungkin Anjong, mungkin ada lagi bilik project. Whatever project you name, between Petronas as well as the contractor of Petronas, such as Shell, Murphy and all the other players. Ladies and gentlemen, I think I fail my duty if I don't talk about Sarawak participation in oil and gas. We have a good discussion between us and Petronas on the question of issues related to oil and gas. That's why I was late by 30 minutes. Actually, we were talking about that just now. When there must be collaboration between the Sarawak government and the federal government through Petronas on the question of Sarawak's participation in upstream as well as downstream. I have imposed 5% sales tax on oil and gas. Of course, Petronas may not be happy. But then we want to share wealth together. It was not purposely done because the question of royalty has been there, ding dong, ding dong, ding dong. No conclusion. And therefore, we have to take another route by imposing sales tax 5%. Of course, the players are also not happy. The reason is it may add a cost to investor. But I am very flexible. As long as I got the revenue which is equivalent, we can reduce the tax, but there must be revenue equivalent because of the fact that oil and gas are within Sarawak territory. So, ladies and gentlemen, saya telah menubuhkan Petros. Petros adalah regulatory body. Petros can work with Petronas and also the other organization where the benefit will be mutual. I have indicated to the federal government of our desire to participate actively in both upstream and downstream. As far as downstream, as you know, the state government is going to establish methanol plant. We are working together with Petronas as our marketing agent because Petronas is good in marketing methanol from Labuan facility, and Sarawak is going to have our own facility to produce methanol. And methanol is a base for other derivatives in petrochemical. And therefore, Sarawak's direction is to participate in both downstream as well as upstream. The next issue is, of course, maintenance. That's where people like Blue Dot Yard and other companies can deliver the task of maintaining whatever facilities we have in Sarawak. Finally, I would like to mention here that Petros is not like one MDB. There has been a malicious website written on Petros. Petros is a regulatory body. And as I said, we have this transparent management. Petros is just an organization set up by the government to make sure that Sarawakians can participate in both upstream and downstream. There's no such thing as, you know, something like one MDB. That website is malicious and it has a malicious intention. We would like to mention here that Sarawak government is a accountable government and a responsible government. We are transparent. At the end of the day, we want to deliver things to Sarawakian. Bak kata denan, jangan kita putih mata. Kita melihat saja wang ambil minyak dan gas. Kalau kita melihat saja, Ailio kita kun. Tapi kita hendaklah bersama-sama. Takkan kita ngambil air saja. Not lain yang orang lain ngambil. Kita kongsilah sama. Atuklah kerja kita bersama dengan pihak agensi persekutuan demi untuk kepentingan bersama. Akhir sekali saya mengucap terima kasih kepada Petronas for your understanding, though we have been brought to court by you. But I'm very patient man. We can collaborate, and therefore what is important is the interest of the country as well as the interest of Sarawak to be defended. With that, with this new yard, we have invested a lot through Boat Dot Yard. I hope we get more job in order to maintain this yard. With that, thank you very much. And I wish both Blue Dot Yard and Petronas all the best. Thank you.